Good evening, little ones. It's time to go to sleep. It's time to relax your bodies. Feel your head on your soft pillow and your warm blankies. Close your eyes and start to dream and think of happy thoughts. Think of being warm under your covers. Think of mommy or daddy hugging you. Think of a fun day at the beach. Think of your little feet splashing in the water or playing in the sand. Think of a day at the fair, going on all your favorite rides. Maybe eating cotton candy or popcorn, playing games and winning prizes. Think of your birthday. We're all happy on our birthday. Think of your cake. Think of your gifts. Just use your imagination. And as you think of all these happy thoughts, relax your mind, your body. Breathe deeply into your nose and out through your nose. Listen to the sound of my voice as you drift off into La La Land. And now, get ready to hear one of my favorite stories, The Very Hungry Caterpillar. While I'm reading the story, imagine being a caterpillar. What would it be like? Think of becoming a beautiful butterfly. What color are your wings? What would you eat? Where would you live? The Very Hungry Caterpillar by Eric Carle. In the light of the moon, a little egg lay on a leaf. One Sunday morning, the warm sun came up and pop, out of the egg came a tiny and very hungry caterpillar. He started to look for some food. On Monday, he ate through one apple, but he was still hungry. On Tuesday, he ate through two pears, but he was still hungry. On Wednesday, he ate through three plums, but he was still hungry. On Thursday, he ate through four strawberries, but he was still hungry. On Friday, he ate through five oranges, but he was still hungry. On Saturday, he ate through one piece of chocolate cake, one ice cream cone, one pickle, one slice of Swiss cheese, one slice of salami, one lollipop, one piece of cherry pie, one sausage, one cupcake, and a slice of watermelon. That night, he had a stomach ache. The next day was Sunday again. The caterpillar ate through one nice green leaf, and after that, he felt much better. Now, he wasn't hungry anymore. He wasn't a little caterpillar anymore. He was a big, fat caterpillar. He built a small house called a cocoon around himself. He stayed inside for more than 2 weeks. He then nibbled a hole in the cocoon and pushed his way out. He was a beautiful butterfly. The end. I hope you enjoyed that story, little one. How was it pretending to be a butterfly? My wings were pink and purple. What color were yours? Good night, sweetie pie.